wasn't my fault.
I don't really believe in the construct of time.
Two guesses who made us late.
Don't even start. Just sit down.
Does anybody have a water? Not from the audience, because that's going to lead to something else.
This is some drool I've had the last hour.
Yeesh.
All right.
Well, that was a great...
Only in Scotland could you have water named Radnor.
Yeah,
it's funny to me.
Sit down, fool.
I've got nothing to ask you. You've missed all the fun.
This seems familiar.
I'm on the right side.
I know. We always make sure we now have to sit. Who knows a show called Retro Replay? If we ever sit on the other opposite side of the couch, people are like going, no.
I don't like it.
Mm-mm.
It's like when Troy parts his hair the other way, the world loses its cool.
That's why he's just going straight back. Look at that. You could surf on that hair. That's nice. That's real nice.
Now, talking about Retro Replay, before you came here, maybe this is why you're late.
What?
You had a fan meet in London.
Yeah.
Dude.
I saw the photo. It looked amazing what some people have been taking. And you were on a ship.
No, we weren't on a ship.
Oh, look at that.
We were on the ship. We were on the
that
replica.
That ship was the ship.
Replica of Sir Francis Drake's ship, the Golden Hind, which he circumnavigated the globe in. And this ship, this replica, was manned by a crew and actually went around the world twice. So, which is seems foolish and just...
And true story is the width of this stage.
Yeah, the whole thing.
Something that circumnavigated the globe is the width of this stage.
Terrifying.
That's terrifying. And we got on it.
You know what's the most disappointing part, though? You were on a ship.
Yeah.
You didn't reenact Titanic. Who would have been Kate? Who would have been Leo?
I think I would have been Leo.
Yeah, because I would have let him drown.
Now,
sorry, I don't like.
I don't know about you, but does anyone want to see what that would look like?
That's years of stand-up right there. That's exactly what it is.
Come on, I want to see the reenactment if yous two is if yous did Titanic.
Am I Kate? I'm Kate Winslet.
Yeah,
you're so stupid, Rose. You're so stupid. That's a line from the movie.
Go, Troy! Don't let go!
He should have pushed her off the boat.
Never let go, Rose. Okay, gotta let go. Gotta let go. Sorry. Sorry. Are you gonna drown? Sorry.
There was enough room.
By the
there
way.
There was enough room.
There was enough
hey,
room.
Hey, here's a thought. You know, mate, 10 minutes on, 10 minutes off. We'll keep talking. No.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, bye. I'll love you forever.
Let go.
I'm sorry to ruin that movie for you.
I want a remake now with these two starring it. It'd be the best parody ever.
You're so stupid, Rose. We went and saw that because they re-released it in the theaters. And we're sitting there. I was like, oh, my God, my wife is the biggest fan of this movie. And her bright-eyed face was like, this movie is a piece of shit. It was like so, it was so bad. And when he said, you're so stupid, Rose. We all were like, that's an abusive boyfriend. I mean, I get he's supposed to be Irish. Not at all.
So,
a question.
Yeah. How was the fan meet in London? What was that like, meeting all those fans, having fun on a ship?
Dude, it was the coolest thing. We thought that maybe 8 people would show up to this thing. We've been in Johannesburg, South Africa.
Really?
Well, you're lost. Why are you here?
All of that.
All of where?
Cowboy.
All of this was from
all
Johannesburg?
That cowboy.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
real good.
Sorry.
So all of we went out to Johannesburg. We had 2 days in London and we're like, well, we can either just sit here in our hotel rooms and be sad and drink a lot of Guinness, or we can go out and do something cool. So the last 2 days we're like, hey, what if we just did a replayer meetup? We knew that the 26th was gonna be outbreak day. There was a little announcement on the 24th. Do you know what the game The Last of Us is?
No.
Okay. So.
Who knows Uncharted?
Damn it. Know your audience.
I love Scotland.
So we decided, why don't we do this? And then you're very good. Yes, you're very talented.
We love you, Nolan.
So
you shut your mouth.
This guy Gary, who takes care of the Golden Hind, said, "Well, why don't you guys come do it on the deck of our ship?" So we did that, and then 75 people showed up in the middle of the day, in the middle of the week, to come and just hang out with us for 2 hours. And we all got down into the hold of the ship and just had this great little Q&A hang. We drank beers together, and we celebrated Outbreak Day together. They're learning. So it was super fun. This was a great moment. We had...
That's me.
That was him.
His jacket.
The coolest part of this, and this is why we love our channel so much, is that everybody that's there met everybody, and everybody left with a friend and a smile.
You also told people to stop back after as well and hang out, if I remember right. So you told everyone to stick around, get to know each other, and make some new friends.
Yeah,
as well.
We gamified the meetup. So if you took a picture, and I was like, "Hey, if you're in the shot," you had to go and get everybody's handle, YouTube name,
exactly,
whatever, so that at the end of it, you could send the picture to them, at them on Twitter or Instagram, and connect. And that's all we want to do, is we want to build this community. And there's a lot. Where are my replayers at? Right. This is why we're here, is because you guys, we're coming to see you. You're not coming to see us. You feel me? So that's why we're here.
Yeah. Now, talking about a connection, yous obviously have great chemistry. You'll deny it and say you don't like each other, but yous have great chemistry. And there's obviously a romance of trolling. Troy and Nolan.
I love that I'm first.
Yeah, but Noy doesn't sound as good.
It doesn't. It sounds like a stroke.
No, he always finishes first.
So obviously...
You're on fire today.
I'm drunk. I'm in Scotland, I'm drunk.
Moving on.
Hey!
Okay. Now, I want to play a game of Mr. and Mrs., but Mr. and Mr. And obviously, I thought, you know what?
Hi.
I've got a color print at work. Go a bit crazy.
He always has something.
Yes.
You know me so well. So, there we go. Okay. I'm going to ask you some questions, and you're going to hold up. Yeah, the Troy photo didn't turn out as good as I expected.
All right. I think it looks great.
Better than so many jokes.
I am. It's like literally
probably
just
the
like
same joke.
This is a constipation face.
Oh.
No doubt. That's like,
Mr. North, come out with your hands up. We have you surrounded.
Funny or not, that's
Nolan,
actually
they
where
found
I got
the
it
body
from the police station website. So that was
that's,
really happy.
That's where you would find that, or post office, or milk carton. All right, go ahead.
So,
what are we doing?
So what's the
I'm going to ask a question, and you're going to reveal to us who is the one most likely to be that way. And then we'll see if you agree. So, for example, who is the grumpiest in the mornings?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do a really tough one. Who is the best game player? That's him in Australia. Who is most likely to have a tantrum when they don't win a game?
Although, anybody who knows, he did get a little upset.
A little.
Who has the biggest potty mouth when playing a game?
No.
Oh, no, I go bad.
Not on camera. On camera.
Watch Shaq Fu. I did not. My mother called me. It was not good.
Okay. Ow, I chipped a tooth.
Who is most likely to eat the last bit of food and lie about it?
Last bit of food and lie about it? I'm a liar. I lie to my mother. I don't care.
Even though she's a beautiful woman. Yes.
Who is the better looking?
Back in my day, I put a few backs on mattresses. But now I just want to go to sleep.
Now it's just your own.
I sleep on my side.
Final question, then we'll move on. Who is most likely to take these photos home and cuddle them when they sleep?
What's that?
Who is the most likely to take these photos home and cuddle them when they sleep?
No way, really?
We work together a lot.
That's the button, right? You do the button. It's like both of us.
I'm going to hold your picture while looking at mine.
I'm so glad you said hold the picture when he looks at it. But you can keep them. Those are yours.
Oh,
no, we absolutely won't.
You're welcome. So let's talk retro replay.
Okay.
You know, it's a fairly new YouTube channel compared to most, but it already has such a strong fan base, such a strong following. What is it like knowing that you've had this impact on so many people around the world enjoying watching your content?
It never surprises us. Like when we, again, we didn't think that we were down in Johannesburg. We're 10,000 miles away from home, which sounds like a made-up number. And we walked out Sunday night to do our Retro Replay live show. Who's coming tomorrow for that? Okay, cool. And it was packed. And we didn't think that, we're like, no one's going to know what this thing is. And people showed up, and we had an amazing time. It was probably one of the best shows we've ever had. And the reason why, there's a song that we're going to sing, spoiler, and they started singing it before we did. I was like, what the crap? People know this already. The fact that people show up at super late on Thursday evening or your Friday morning sometimes to chat live with us blows us away. And it's been the greatest thing. We've had some funny jokes and some great moments. But the greatest accomplishment this thing has done in the last year and a half is it's made friends that would not have been. Brandy, where are you at? Bam. Brandy came from Texas just to hang out with Kelly in Sweden. See? It's that shit, man.
Yeah.
So this is why we're not on this couch, but this is why we get on the couch, is because two people literally across the world from each other can find friendship and get tattoos together. They got tattoos together.
What did you just get?
I didn't.
Is that Pokemon? I can't see it.
Wolf and tiger, or wolf and two wolves.
Two wolves.
Two wolves walk into a bar.
Yeah, and now, I don't know if anyone saw the promo this week for Retro Replay where you had a little bit of a fight.
I mean, we had a disagreement.
A little bit. Because of the game choice. But we found a compromise.
Found a compromise.
Yeah.
Did you know what we're talking about?
So the first, do we have that?
I don't think we've got it handy. We can try and find it. We'll get it on towards
it.
The end.
But we, Retro Replay was born out of, we're going to play some old games and kind of, you know, get through it. And he found out that I had never played Uncharted, ever, any of them. And then he came up with the idea that people need to see this. So we did. We did the definitive playthrough on the channel where I went through, played poorly. Not going to lie. Somebody today came up. Who was that? Came up today and gave me a T-shirt. Circle is for cover. Where's Kelly? It's Kelly, right?
Cassie.
No, Cassie, right? Yes, Cassie gave me the T-shirt. You didn't give it to me. You gave it to him to give to me.
She didn't want to stand in your line.
It wasn't a line. No, I'm kidding. There was a huge line. Huge line. It was huge. It's a beautiful one. It's the best line.
Hey, don't laugh. You guys got your own crazy hair, blonde dude that's trying to run this country, so slow your roll a little bit.
They're like a sitcom. They should get together.
Can you imagine that? Trump and Boris going through the country, messing it up just as fast as they can. Hey!
Coming live on Retro Replay 2020.
To answer your question, sorry. So we had we kind of put it out to the community. What, as Troy says, what do we play next? And everybody was like, going to be Uncharted 2, right? And then we got a bunch of people who said we should be playing Last of Us. And yeah, so we got into a little scuffle and then decided, why not play both? So that was what the big announcement was the other day. And so if you subscribe to the channel for free, please, just click on that link and then you can watch me fail over and over and over.
I feel like they deserved a little bit more of a woo-woo because we just announced we're going to play Uncharted 2 and The Last of Us at the same time. Come on, y'all.
That's what we're talking about.
That's what you call a crowd pleaser.
Can we have a 10-hour video of just Nolan failing? You know how you can do 10 hours on YouTube? Just you failing?
We can do 20. There's a lot of failing out there.
We got to hear a lot of Kid and Nate. And now you're going to hear a lot of Joel. Joel.
I played more than that. If you know, anybody know when you die in the game, it goes to black and white? I saw more black and white than color. I mean, it was like, oh.
Yeah, the death screens are a little different in The Last of Us. You know the one where the bloater does the, yeah, that's going to be a fun one.
You know what I think? What's funny is, like, we mo-capped everything but the actual death. And it's funny that, like, it's almost like the Family Guy limbs when Nate
Ragdoll.
Dies. Like,
bah, bah.
I thought it was a glitch. It's like, no, you broke every bone in your body when you fall from that height.
So, talking about fans, I've asked you questions. God, I've been speaking with you for over a year now, really. I'm sick of asking you questions, so I opened it up to Twitter. Now, this is how big a fan base you have. No one follows me on Twitter, yet I got loads and loads of questions. So people are checking out your hashtag all of the time, which is amazing. So I found some questions so that way your fans can ask you some of those. So I believe they'll load them up on the screen any second now.
Hey.
There we go. So they've probably had this 1,000 plus times, but what advice could they give to anyone trying to make it in the acting, voice acting business? And that is Elliot.
I just quit. Just don't try. Don't even try. Somebody once said that if you can do anything else, do it.
Right.
And you think about it, it's funny, but then you're like, oh, I think I know what you mean. It's something that's really kind of deep inside you that you're driving thing that you want to try. And I found that the success was in the trying. And it just, I don't want to live my life and look back and I wish I had done this, I wish I had done that. I think the most important thing for any actor to understand is that you're enough. Don't try to play a character. Play you as that character. I remember learning one time, like, I went in for a role, I prepared, I was ready, and I thought I nailed it, and I didn't get it, and I was talking to an acting coach I was working with at the time, and he said, and I did the scene for him, he says, it was really good. This is not you. And I said, I don't understand. What do you mean? He said, you're playing, what's the character's name? I said, Paul. He goes, you're playing Paul, the lawyer in Cleveland, Ohio. He said, be Nolan, the lawyer in Cleveland, who happens to be named Paul. And it was just, I know it's a weird little tweak, but if you just, I would almost, it comes off as false. It comes off as disingenuous, this kind of, you're acting, and when you can tell you're acting, you're not just being. And if you're going to be in a series, if you're going to do a movie for any length of time, a video game like Uncharted or Last of Us, you have to be as genuine and authentic in that character as you should be in your own life. And that's something that stuck with me, and since I learn that, I think I got better at doing that.
It's brilliant. The only thing that I would add to it is just remove that little slash. There's no difference.
Oh, yeah.
Acting is acting. And you sometimes get a job that requires you to do this and a job that requires you to do this. Don't try to qualify going in. Just do exactly that. And you said three words that I heard resonate over here. Those three words are so powerful. You are enough. Just you. Don't try to impress anybody ever. Cool?
Awesome answer. Right. Okay, we have the next one coming up now. What would Troy's perfect hat look like? Color, material, number of skulls dangling off it.
I think I know why you chose this question. What? Number of skulls dangling. I'm not wearing it today.
So many things could be switched out for the word skulls there.
Yeah, dicks.
Wow, you just went right to it, didn't you? Okay, all right, well.
I don't know. I mean, I have a fair collection of of hats, of chapeaus, and trilbies. I'm trying to figure out why is zero skulls dangling off of it. Would probably be. I don't know why I need skulls. There should be no hat, unless you're doing something like for Dia de la Muerte, and you have like the little fringe hat. There should be no skulls. No skulls.
Do you have to buy an extra large hat just to keep your hair in the perfect condition?
He just uses mine. Because I have a big head.
No, if I'm wearing a hat, it's because I have quit. This is one reason why I did a mohawk. A, because I'm in my 40s and I've got an awesome son. I'm like, why not? And then as long as I can control it, I'm going to do stuff with it. Why are we talking about my hair? Next question.
I was going to ask for gel tips because, well, you can see. Right, next question. So, if you could cosplay anyone.
I see.
If you could cosplay anyone, who would it be and why? By the way, sorry for poking your eye out. And I believe this is from Manchester because I remember seeing that cosplay as well.
So now I understand why the skull's dangling from it.
This is a totally different person. It's just very weird coincidence.
We get a chance to see a lot of amazing cosplayers. People come up, and you're going to the cons, people coming up to see us. I love the Nathan Drakes because it's like jeans and a T-shirt. Yeah. And then you get the guy who's like, I'm a Transformer, and I have 27 pounds of plastic.
Fully and articulating and working.
Completely sweating and just going, that's a lot of work. Less is more for me just because I'm lazy. But I don't know. I don't know who I'd be. Princess Peach, I think I'd be great at that.
Nail it.
Nailing it.
I saw once a 9-year-old good man.
You're a little too enthusiastic back there.
It was like a 9-year-old kid that was cosplaying as Michael Douglas from Falling Down.
Wait, where was that?
And I don't remember where it was.
That's awesome.
It was, and I was the only one. This was a cool, like, if that's the character you chose to cosplay as, you're a cool kid. And I looked at him, and I'm like, signing it. I look at him and went, dude, are you Michael Douglas from Falling Down? And he looks up at me and goes, you're the only one to get it. I'm like, I want to be your best friend. Like, you're a... I was like, people are like, are you just like an angry Mormon? What have you seen the movie Falling Down? So you understand. It's like the pocket protector, the glasses, the white short sleeve shirt, and the time was like, are you Michael Douglas from Falling Down?
By the way, that's got to be the most cynical fourth grader on the planet.
Ever. It's like, I'm over it. And he just gets
out
of walks out of class.
What's the point?
What's the point? If you know anything about me, I have a real big obsession with Daredevil. I wouldn't mind doing that. I wouldn't mind like cosplaying as Daredevil. I need to get my abs like in way better shape because I ain't doing like. There's some Spider-Man walking around here. I'm like, what's up, y'all? I see you working. But yeah, that'd be fun. And you could do the mask, and maybe no one would know who I am.
Now, to flip that question around.
Okay.
If you had to dress Nolan in a cosplay, what would it be? And if you had to dress Troy in a cosplay, what would it be? So you could choose their outfit. And then make this a Halloween retro replay where you make them wear the outfits.
100% Pennywise for him. Just torture. And then like dump a bucket of spiders on him. Just torture.
I would dress him as Daredevil to make his dreams come true, make him happy. But I guess the spiders are funny, too.
Yeah. Well played. That was well played.
Feel like shit now? That's what we do. Good friends. Just make each other feel like shit.
Right, you know what? I want to come out to you guys now, because does anyone have any questions? No? Brilliant. Right, I can continue. No, I'm going to come out, so I saw your hand first. I'll come to you.
Hi there. Hi. So how did Retro Replay come about? Did you two sort of decide this yourselves, or did someone approach you to discuss it?
the story keeps morphing, but we always wanted, we always enjoy doing things together. There used to be Q&A panels at cons for a long time where, you know, I would be Nolan North and then Troy would be next or vice versa. And at some point, one of us, I don't remember who started, we'd start crashing each other's panel. And I personally found that the last end of that, whenever you would crash the panel, it got more interesting, funny, you know, and people seemed to have a better time. So when Uncharted 4, we were doing promotion for that, we did a lot of the Q&A things together at cons. And then, I don't know, somehow we ended up in this studio with our producing partners and just said, hey, you know, people play your games. Wouldn't it be an interesting perspective, you guys playing games? And the first time we ever did the show, we sat down and they got the cameras ready and they were like, well, what are you going to do? We're like, we have no idea.
No idea.
Turn it on and let's see what happens. You have anything? I mean,
I've always found it mind-blowing that he had never, up till, you know, a few months ago, had never played Uncharted. And I was like, you have to do that. But in order to understand how great it is, you really need to understand, you need to meet the giants upon whose shoulders we are standing. And so it's like, let's take this all the way back. And we started playing through these retro titles. There's a lot that I played that I was excited about him experiencing, and there's a lot that I didn't get to play because I didn't have a lot of money growing up. And before there were Let's Plays, I would go over to my friend's house and watch them play, and every once in a while I'd be like, can I see it for a second? No. So this was my chance to go back now and actually play through these things. So we kind of always knew that at some point we were going to play Uncharted, but we didn't know when. And so it finally just got to the point to where we discovered this love. He had this language that was built, and it was like, now it's time. Now let's play through Uncharted. And we were able to bring in our friend, Jacksepticeye, to say, hey, would you help us kick this off? And he was kind enough to kind of be like, let's do a playthrough. You know who Jacksepticeye is, right? All right, cool. Seven people. He's quite popular. So we kind of always knew that this is where we were going. But we had no idea that this is where we would be. Does that make sense? Cool.
Next question here.
What do you think of the Uncharted short film starring Nathan Fillion?
I thought it was great. You know, he's been a fan forever. As he said, it was an itch he wanted to scratch, and he scratched it. He was great. You know, he got one thing wrong, though. It's always punch. He in this one part, he went, kitty got wet. And it's punch, kitty got wet.
Bam.
You don't punch on the kitty got wet. That's the after part. You got to wait till he's down. So he's lying on the ground going, kitty what? Yeah, I scratched it.
Okay, next question.
I'll just add to that. Everyone asking about an Uncharted movie. There have been five, if you want to count Golden Abyss. And they're movies that you get to play. I don't know if I need another one. I don't know if I need one that I don't get to play. You know what I mean? Because I don't know if that's an Uncharted thing. Anybody else feel the same way? Nine people. All right.
Video games are not for me. Anyway, Troy, Nolan, you've had experience with motion capture throughout the vast majority of your acting roles. What advice would you give if any of us happened to be doing any motion capture work?
Motion capture work is basically theater. So anybody who's done, any actor who's done theater, it's the same thing except your costume happens to be this ridiculously tight suit. But, you know, the thing is, Gordon Hunt was the director of the first three Uncharted. He was brilliant, and one of the things that he used to preach to us was stay specific. Keep it small, keep it real. I remember when early in my career when people would we'd go into voice games that had been mo-capped at the time, motion captured by stunt people, sometimes people worked at the development office. We would watch what they did and have to dub what their movements. And there's always that guy who would sit there, let me tell you something, I'm getting out of here. And it would be this, all these gestures and just ridiculous movement. when nobody talks like that. You know, not once have I said, that was funny. Ha, this is, You know, you keep it small, keep it real, authentic. We go back to that word, authentic. I think staying specific with movements, you know, little things, keep subtle, all that kind of thing. It's not anything, it's not a skill that, anything you would do on a live stage or in a movie, or it's the same thing. Like Troy said earlier, there's no slash between acting, voice acting, motion capture. It's all the same.
Everything that informs you as an actor in TV and film, the sets, the props, your wardrobe, all of that is gone. It's gone. It's stripped from you. You are forced to focus on what you inherently and quintessentially understand about that character, and uniquely understand about the character. Because our set is a soundstage, and our props are made of foam, and our wardrobe, wear good underwear. Because it's very revealing. And you've got a camera that's mounted 8 inches from your face with a light that illuminates your face whenever you're rolling.
And you have to ignore it.
And you have to ignore it. And so does the other person. You're looking at what that other person is wearing and their camera and their face, and you realize, I look that ridiculous. So you have to overcome those obstacles. And I've seen people who are put in that situation when they don't have those trappings to rely on actually reduce their performance, and it actually become way more nuanced and small. Because once they get over that fear, it actually becomes a much more grounded thing, because they don't have all these things to kind of tether themselves to. So yeah, be specific is a really great thing to tell somebody. But also just make sure that in any role that you have, no matter what the medium that you're performing it in, that there's something that you know about that character that nobody else does, and you ground yourself in that. Cool. Who else? I love your beanie, by the way. The Daredevil beanie. It's yours. Can I have it? I'm joking. Please, I don't want it. You can have it.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, Christ. What are some of the biggest changes that you've noticed since you've been working in the games industry? And also, is somebody feeding Drew while you guys are away?
I heard one of the biggest changes. What did I miss?
Did you?
What?
Is anyone feeding Drew?
Did you let him out? No, we left some newspapers down.
Yeah, he'll be fine.
And he's got one of those like gerbil things. You like lick
and
it for water.
And he eats his own poo.
He does. For fun, we can't keep him from doing it.
Some of the biggest changes that I've seen just goes to it's again acting. Our job is to deliver a performance. Microphone, camera, mocap stage, live theater, doesn't matter. Deliver the performance. The biggest changes have come on the developer's side, where a perfect example, quickly, is Uncharted Drake's Fortune. Drake and Elena run over, jump into a Jeep, and take off. They rented a Jeep for the day. And it had, like, mouse droppings and smelled of urine. It was terrible. We jumped in a couple times, banged our knees because it was all metal and the seats were kind of dirty. By the time Uncharted 2 came around, I'm like, well, where's the Jeep? And they go, well, no, we don't have it. They have these wooden blocks that they kind of put together, kind of like Legos, to look exactly like a Jeep. We don't really need a Jeep because, you know, it's not markered. We it's a digital Jeep. Got it. Uncharted 3 comes along. And now it's not even, we don't even need it to look like a Jeep. We got seats and a flatbed and steering wheel, and there's a pedal here. Uncharted 4, it's like, here's your steering wheel, go grab two chairs. Because we don't need, it just got pared down because the technology was easier. And going back to what Troy was saying about motion capture performances, the thing about it is, somebody once asked me, they said, they came to the studio, which at the time, you know, looks like this room. And they go, how do you do this? There's nothing here. I said, yeah, or there's everything. It's your imagination. You're running around like a kid. And, you know, I can still remember that Uncharted 2 where I jumped from the train, from the truck. They had wooden Jeep, and I remember sitting there, and they were like, are you sure you want to do this? I'm like, yeah, this is fun. And I was still young enough to be able to do it. And I jumped, and I grabbed onto the thing, and, you know, it had to do that heroic thing. And it was like, yeah, that was one of the coolest moments because we were playing, and it was so much fun. That was the same time that we also did where I jumped up, and she goes, I said, come on, scooch over. And she, scooch? And she made that up right on the spot. That was the spontaneity and the brilliance of it. We were kids playing. And especially in that that particular project, you're playing in your backyard, your kids. That's the clubhouse. Now it's a treasure ship. And the lawn is the ocean. And go.
Unfortunately, out of time.
Oh, well.
Oh.
It's because you
were
late.
I don't really believe in time as a construct.
Why do you not believe that? Because
I don't
it's
know,
like.
Because I'm some tired, sleepy person. Does anybody know who this is?
Yes, hey. It's on news, and I am on news.
And I'm running for government. For those who don't know who it is, it's a very confusing face on your face right now. Watch the show, it makes a lot more sense.
Okay. So if you haven't subscribed to Retro Replay, go do that.
And plugs.
If you're around tomorrow, please, please come check out the live show.
Do you know what
show.
Time we're doing it at?
3:30. 3:30.
It's 2:30.
31, 2:31. Okay, he has a theory that everybody's 2:30 is the most talked about time. And now I've polluted all your minds. 2:30, you're going to start hearing that. What time's your appointment?
It's the most reference time, 2:30. And it's a dad joke. When do you know when it's time to go to the dentist? It's 2:30.
Very right? funny.
And they'll have more jokes like that at their autograph booth. And no doubt photos are available as well for the rest of the weekend as well.
Yes.
So please check them out. You can see they're absolutely amazing. Subscribe to Retro Replay. And I hope to see you again in the future.
You will.
And I'll have more silly games for you as well because I know how much you love them. Let's have a try, Nolan!
My face. Lucky gal in the front row has my face. Oh, I gotta go.